And hello, fellow gamers. I am back playing more video games, as I am wont to do. This time it's Sonic the Hedgehog on the Genesis. This is a Jeremy Tries, because I don't actually have a whole lot of experience with this game. I know the basic premise. There's a blue hedgehog, and he's kind of edgy or something. Or at least that's what Sega would want you to believe. And it's a very colorful game, and it runs pretty fast, and I'm probably going to be playing it wrong because I'm not going to be running fast, because that's not how I roll. But as usual, as is the case for all of the games on my channel, whether you're watching on Twitch live right now or you're watching on the YouTube recording, this is a real physical cartridge of Sonic the Hedgehog on a real Genesis, a Model 1 Genesis specifically. Oh, that was close. Look at all this shit. Excelente. As Teddy Forsman might say. Can I actually get around this thing? Yes, I can. Blast processing, yo! Actually, I'm not sure they started using that term until... Was it Sonic 2 that they started using that term, or did they start with this game? Because Sonic 2 definitely does run faster than this, and that's partially because... Oh shit! Hit the thing. I don't know if that counted or not. Sonic 2, you gain the ability to, you know, crouch and then tap the button and do like a super speed dash. Can't do that in this game. And we have this weird rotating stage. I think that's what that giant ring at the end of the last level did. This is actually pretty hard to control. And that's that. Kitsune is watching on the Twitch stream right now, says, "You've had over 25 years to do this game. No excuses, so buck up." Kitsune's just kidding. No one's a bigger dick on my channel than me, dammit. Take that, you fox person, you. Oh, shit, it grabbed me. One thing I don't like is if you try to jump off of an angle in this game, you jump perpendicularly to the surface instead of jumping straight up, so it's kind of awkward. Like, a couple of times what I've tried to do is going up a slope like this, I've tried to jump to, you know, get up the slope faster, but it's kind of counterproductive. And that's not really that big of a complaint, that's just, you know, that's how this game works. It's not a Mario game, you know? It plays its own way. Ooh, what's that? It's an invincibility. I think I just got a checkpoint. What the fuck? Thing appearing out of the wall right there. So help me out, chat. What causes that big-ass ring at the end of the level to appear? Is it dependent on the number of rings that I have when I get to the end? Whoa! Oh, there it is again. Oh, shit. Get it. Yes. Pause for a second. Because Kitsune said something interesting. He said, "Your version is missing one specific special effect from the Mega Drive original because I'm playing on a Genesis. Can you identify it?" One specific special effect. I have no idea, but I'd like to know. And Jormware has joined us. Welcome, Jormware. Amanda45 says, "Did you see Mike Matei streaming Zelda on Twitch?" I saw the notifications for it, but I didn't tune in because I was at work at the time. Or sleeping. But I also don't want any spoilers because I plan to play that myself soon. Kisune says to get the bonus ring at the end, you have to have 50 plus rings, which is kind of what I was thinking because I was watching the number when I completed that level. He says, and there must be more emeralds remaining. Emeralds? Oh, that sucked. Green Hill Zone, Act 329. Or 3, you know, give or take 326. Woo! And then we get counterproductivity. I saw that one up there. Wait, can you get it? Don't do that. Don't do that. Stop. 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 Oh, there was a thing up there. I thought I was jumping up on top of the tree. I want to get that one up. Nope. Oh, that's probably how you get it. Okay, let's do that on purpose this time. Nope. Fuck. I'm not doing the controls right. Yeah, piss. Fuck it. Ow. That's kind of dastardly. Rotating spike thing. God damn it, this place has crabs. Bane of my fucking existence, these crabs. Yes, I know they're robot crabs, but they're still goddamn fucking crabs. Oh shit, damn! No damage invincibility. That was just dumb, I should have stayed up there. There's a bumper thing up there. Oh man, I hate not being able to jump up the slope. I could probably start by going faster at the bottom of the slope. Woo! Boss fight coming? Looks like it. And man, Robotnik, which is what he's called in this game, has got one giant nut. Fuck, nut. Fuck, nut. Now one thing I do like here is, even if you, in Sonic games, even if you do take damage, you drop all your rings, but as long as you can pick one of them back up before you take another hit, you can keep on trying. Omni 45 says no, it thought you wanted to make sure it wasn't the same game. It wasn't. I don't understand. Please clarify. So, odd thing about the Sonic games is, even though I never played them back when they were new because I was a hopeless Nintendo fanboy at the time, I still somehow managed to memorize all the music. And I've always loved the music in Sonic games. And at the time when I was a Nintendo fanboy, I didn't want to admit that I loved the music, but I definitely did. Thankfully, I grew out of that fanboy phase, learned to broaden my gaming horizons, and since then have experienced countless excellent gameplay experiences that I would not have experienced otherwise. Should I do something with that box first? What if I push it over here? Oh, I can just use it right here. There we go. Because what I was going to do is try and stop it right here and then stand on the switch myself and then try and push the block off the edge before the thing fell back down. But I guess that's what it's for. That's what the box is for. Oh, tricky. Look at that. Some of the boxes don't fall. So you think to yourself, oh, I'll just jump and try and land where it looks like the box is going to fall. And then they don't all do that. Whoa. Lost my shield. Piss loaf face. It's not that bad, actually. Anything up there? Nope. Shit. No bonus stage for me. Oh, I think I see what you're saying now, Oddman845. Basically, you're saying that I'm streaming this game because I wanted to make sure that I wasn't streaming what inevitably everybody else is streaming right now, which is Zelda on the Switch. If that's what you meant, then that is exactly it. Well, that's part of the reason. Give me about 10 years, and then I'll stream Zelda on the Switch on my channel. Whoa, fuck! Oh, there was some actual damage invincibility that came in handy. How are you supposed to get her across there? Ow. Oh, piss. Good, at least you can push multiple boxes in this game. Oh, nice! A lava flow just waiting for me. Shit. Trying to go too fast in a Sonic game. Shit. And then I get killed by the derpy spiky caterpillar. Kitsune says, I knew it, this effect was removed too. On the Mega Drive, the blocks actually float with buoyancy in the lava. Huh. And they took that out in the Genesis version? That's weird. Also, there's a time limit in this game, so... Omni 45 says, that's not what I meant at all, but close enough. So let me try and re-decode this. Said no, because I thought you wanted to make sure it wasn't the same game. Zelda, the Wii U, and the Switch. Omni 45, are you the CIA agent? You talking in code right now? Kitsune says you'd never risk the 10-minute limit. Oh, duh, of course, the timer's counting up, not down. which explains why when I started the level I only had like 10 seconds, and I was wondering how I could have possibly gotten as far as I did when that's how much time you start the level with. Now, I just had a funny thought. I bet you could control this game with an Atari 2600 joystick. Because even though the Genesis controller has three buttons on it on the default controller, A, B, and C, they all do the same thing. Shit. What I need to stop doing is just flying towards the edge of the screen hoping that I'm gonna land on something. Oh, what the pud? Can you only hit those guys on the head? Whoa! Game's fucking with me. Burp. Very good graphics for the time. Although I saw a little bit of sprite overload going on there. Still though, it does take a lot to do it. Oh, come on. It kind of like rocketed me off of that. That jump back there. Piss. I know everybody that's actually worth a damn at this game right now is watching me play and they're just cringing to death. Points were going up from hitting those blocks. I wonder if you hit enough of them, you can get a 1-up. Of course, that's me thinking in Mario terms. That may not be applicable here. Fuck the lava. Shit, I saw it too late. I was trying to go back so I could jump on top of it. It fell on top of me anyway. What? What were those things? Mario 45 says 2 plus 2 equals fish. I've never seen that equation. You working with imaginary numbers? Mario 45 says the square root of Sonic is car. My favorite ice cream flavor is B. My favorite number is blue. I think you need to get on some kind of meds there, Mario 45. Your brain is not working correctly. Kizune says, in reference to when I mentioned the three-button controller, that's why I said the default controller, because he says technically six buttons. I'm actually playing right now on the six-button controller because, number one, this has a longer cable on it, and number two, the D-pad for it is more comfortable and more responsive for me anyway. So instead of having two redundant buttons, if this game would actually recognize the three extra ones, we'd have five redundant buttons. Kizuni says, I actually hate the standard controller. I only play on the 6 button. So we're in agreement there. It says, point accumulation from bouncing off the block stops at 1,000. He says, you need 100 rings or a 1-up monitor to earn a 1-up. Kizuni says, have you never played the entire series ever? I have barely played it. I've played the first few levels of Sonic 2 and a little bit of Sonic CD, a little bit of Sonic Adventure. None of those on my channel, just personally. So, yeah. I don't have a whole lot of experience with the Sonic games. Because it says these basic mechanics are universal through the series. Well, at least I knew the thing about the rings, okay? Dormer says, I need a jet. I'll catch back up on the recording. Thank you for thank you for tuning in, Dormware. Upmanet45 says, you mean the correction building. I think perhaps there's something wrong with you tonight, Upmanet45. Do you have the do you have the Switch craze? You know, the desire for a Switch has made you craze? Piss. Ooh, those just break away on their own. App, that was dumb. I should have just kept going. Okay, question. This game over, where do I continue from? Is it from the beginning of the game? Looking like yes so far. Sega. Yep, beginning of the game, no continues. Damn, harsh. I bet all these enemies have names too, don't they? Like that jumping robo piranha fish. Its name is probably jumping robo piranha fish. And those are goddamn crabs. Look it up in the manual, it actually says that, goddamn crabs. First instance of swearing in a video game manual, Sonic the Hedgehog. Holy shit! Whoa! I guess I never noticed before that that thing actually sucks you in when you hit it. Bump. And what do the bumpers in here do? The R and the peppermint and the down, it looks like that says. I know what those do. Okay, so Kizuni says there are continues, but I guess you have to collect them. Because he says, if you game over, then you restart at the start of the level if you have continues, which I didn't at the time, apparently. Amanda 45 says, give me the Switch. And he says, AKA the Wii U gamepad with the ends cut off. There's a little bit more to it than that. And Kasune says to Oddman845 says, okay, here you go. And he linked to, I'm guessing what he says is the Wii U gamepad with the ends cut off. And that is not, that is an RF switch. Looking like for the Genesis, probably. And about those bumpers, Kasune says the up and down affect rotational speed of the level, and R reverses the rotation. Okay. He says the red-white wheel, which I called a peppermint, without text is something Sonic can stick to and jump off of. Okay. Excellent. I will keep all that shit. I'll keep all that in mind the next time I get to a bonus stage. Or a boner stage, as I like to call them. Because, you know, I'm 12 years old. Fell off the screen, which means you still die. Mm. See, now you're witnessing a phenomenon that's very, very common to when I play games I'm not familiar with, which is I inevitably get the furthest on my first attempt because I'm being more cautious and being more patient. Subsequent attempts like that, I slowly get more and more annoyed with having to repeat myself, that I start doing more and more stupid shit that I shouldn't do, and I gradually get less and less far and start making more and more mistakes. Which, you know, is probably exactly contrary to the gaming experience of the vast majority of people. Most people are probably, they gradually get further and further as they play. Go back. Yes, got it. Okay, so now that I know more about these things, stick to the peppermint and doesn't seem to work. Well, there it's sort of working until it dumps me off. You hit the R to reverse the rotation direction. Yep. And the stars are obviously just bumpers. And that's speeding it way the hell up. I wonder if you could just try your best to sit there on an up one as long as possible, if eventually it'll just start going nuts. Like the whole level will be spinning around and the system will heat up and explode. There's a clickbait video for you on YouTube. The bonus level in Sonic spun so fast that my Genesis burned up. And then you check the video and he's like not even playing on a real Genesis, he's playing on an emulator and nothing blows up in it and there might not even be a bonus stage in it. Okay, yeah, Kitsune clarified, says that the peppermint things do not negate gravity. Yeah, okay. So then how do those differ from just the ordinary blocks that are on the side? What the piss biscuit? Damn. See? Much worse second attempt. Aha. Kitsune says if you play the special stage long enough, you will hear a short melody play. This signifies acquisition of a continue, so that's how you get continues. And Oddminute45 says, in reference to me saying that I'm 12, he says, hey, I was 12 like 4 months ago. So you're at that wonderful age where, like, where I've been at ever since I was 12, where anyone saying the word penis in any context elicits endless giggling. In fact, there's a clip from a cartoon called Mission Hill, which I think was on Adult Swim for a while, where it's just this guy in a trench coat comes up to, I guess, whoever is the main character in the show, and just says, penis, 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 and then walks away. And I watch that clip a lot, because it's hilarious. Okay, Kitsune says the difference between the peppermint and the regular blocks is that it is stickier. Okay. Let's give this at least one more shot. Oh, something dropped down back there. What was that? It is invincibility. I like the invincibility because I can fuck up all I want and not die, as long as I don't fall into a hole. If this was Sonic 2, I'd be trying to bust open these rocks. But I guess you can't do that in this game. Like, they're just rocks in this game. Mania 45 says, wait, you're still 12? What? I'm mentally 12. Sense of humor, 12. Rotate the other way. So now, my goal now is just to, I'm gonna just try and last as long as I can in here. See if I can get it continue. Is that the only requirement, Kitsune, is that you just have to last for a period of time to get a continue, or do you have to collect a number of rings as well? Bump. Bump. Shit. Yeah. Keep hitting those friggin' up ones. It looks like hitting those also toggles them. It did look like it, at least. It looked like when I hit down... Yeah, I did it right there. Or is that time-dependent as well? Because I'm hitting them sometimes and they don't flip, and other times they do. No, down. Oh, did I just break the game? Cause I think I found a pattern right there. Oh, look at this. All I was doing right there was holding left. Oh, exit. Damn. Kazuna says, I'm pretty sure it is time dependent, because I recall scoring continues with few rings snagged. Apparently you have to dick around longer than I dicked around, which is unusual because I could turn dicking around into an Olympic sport. As is evident by, you know, my gameplay so far. How many rings are in those, the monitor rings? Is it a set amount? No, go back! Ah! It already took control away. Shit! That was just dumb. Like, I saw that coming a mile away, that landing wasn't gonna work. Because I was not spinning. Got some kind of speed power up. Because the, music sped up. Nope. I am not jumping correctly off of the thing. Nope. Ow, fuck. I can't jump off of this thing because I keep hitting my head. See, I'm trying to... I keep hitting my head on that thing right there. If I take a run at it, at least a little bit. There we go. Yes. Need that. Looks like there are 10 rings in the ring monitors. At least there wasn't that one and the last one. Oh, you penis tit. Piss. This ought to be great. No rings. Damn it. He got just barely ahead of me. Fuck! I need a new strategy for that. Because when I said back there, he said you can use the spring in the hill to reach the one up that I was trying to get. And Kitsune says, new stream title, quote, Eggman beats Jeremy. Well, technically, Eggman never beat me in this game. He wasn't called Eggman yet, at least not in this version. Also at the time, Princess Peach was called Toadstool. And let's see, what other regional differences were still in play for character names? And he says, yes, he was. No, he wasn't. He was called Robotnik in this. They didn't start calling him Eggman in North America until... what was it, like Sonic Adventure? He says, Peach was day one. No, it was not. Not in North America. She was called Toadstool. I know you don't like to acknowledge the presence of North American games, but they do exist. Anyhow, I think I am done recording this game for now. Don't know if I will come back and play it again, but I certainly did a lot better on it than I thought I would. So, to wrap up this recording, if you want to know when I am live streaming on Twitch next, then you can either follow me on Twitch or you can follow me on Twitter, which you'll find a link to my Twitter profile right on my YouTube and Twitch channel pages. Or catch me at my typical streaming schedule time, which is on Mondays, Wednesdays, and Fridays at about 9 to 10 p.m. Central Standard Time. So if you would like to tune in again and watch me get beat by this mythical Eggman, whoever he happens to be, then that would be the time that you would do it. So, until then, see ya.